Good morning, my dear students. I'll teach you ICT and I'm your ICT teacher. Okay, so in the last class we discussed about the various calculating devices, and from the various calculating devices and from the calculating devices, how the modern day's computer has been evolved. We talk about this whole journey in the last class only, and we talk about the whole story, and already you must have seen the video that I have sent to you. So even then we will take a quick recap of it. So we'll start with the calculating devices. A recap of that. The very first calculating device was abacus, and it was developed in China. It was, what was the structure? A wooden rectangular frame was there, in which cylindrical wires are there. On that, beads were there, and with the help of those beads, people were doing calculations, simple calculation, just like addition, subtraction, division and multiplication. Now come to Napier's bow. It was the second calculating devices, which was discovered in 1616. It was discovered by John Napier, and again this was the device or calculating device people were using for doing simple calculation. We'll talk about the structure. As the name suggests, only bone, Napier bones. It means, for this devices was made up of bones, and on which numbers were carved with the help of some tools, and people were using this for simple calculation again. Third calculating device was Pascaline, which was the first mechanical calculator. Why we are using the word mechanical? Because it was just the box. It was the structure of this calculating device, just like a box of harmonium. And on the top of that, four or five wheels were there, and these wheels were rotating, and these wheels were rotating, and then thus a process was involved. That is why a process or mechanism was involved. That is why it was called Pascaline, or first mechanical calculator. The word mechanics was used because the physical some process was involved, and that is why it was known as first mechanical calculator. Afterwards it comes Leibniz calculator, which was discovered in 1671. And what was special about that? This is able to find the square root of any number. Earlier whatever calculators were used, those were not able to perform square root, but this calculator was able to perform the square root of numbers also. After that, difference engine came. Engine, again it is mechanical word, and who was the inventor of this device? Charles Babbage, and it was invented in 1822. It was able to prepare free mathematical tables. Before this, only we were able to find out the square root of the numbers. Now this difference engine, which people were using as calculating device, this calculating device was able to reduce mathematical tables. Fine. The next or the sixth calculating device was analytical engine, which was again discovered by Charles Babbage only. It was discovered in 1837, and it only has given the concept of modern computer, means which was having input device, output device and the processing device. So the main term, input, output and processing, that we call IPO cycle, that was given by this machine only, analytical engine, and it was discovered by Charles Babbage. That is why Charles Babbage is considered to be father of computers. Now the seventh one is ENIAC. It was mechanical also, and it was electronic because it was running on the electricity, and it was discovered by John Maculian Eckert. After this, the last one, UNIVAC. UNI was the first commercial available computer to the general people. It was the first commercial, means people were able to buy. This product was openly sold out in the market, and this was available for everyone. The one who were able to pay, they were able to get this computer. And this is known as, in the full form of this is Universal Numerical Integrator and Calculator. It was able to handle the numeric data as well as the textual data. Textual data means a combination of numbers, special characters, plus alphabets. That's it.